Welcome to Street Knowledge. I am Chris Graham. I've got Scott German on the line, Virginia 42, Boise State 23. Dominating performance of the Cavs. Scott, your first impressions after a game that wasn't even as close as that score would indicate?
Just unimaginable. Not that we won, but unimaginable in that it really wasn't that close of a game. I mean, the final score, 42-23, they scored 9 kind of tack-on points there late in the game. But, boy, it just was a came out of nowhere. We talked earlier in the week about the keys to Virginia making it a close game, moral victories and everything. But, it was clear from opening kickoff that they went out there to win, not come back with a moral victory.
Kurt Benkert, 19 of 29, 3 touchdowns, 273 yards. Virginia doesn't turn the ball over again, third time in 4 games. Only 1 turnover all season long for this Cavs offense. The rushing game ends up with 167 yards on 40 carries. Now, 22 yards lost on that last snap over Benkert's head that led to the safety. Scott mentioned the 9 points in the last couple of minutes tacked on in garbage time. That safety allowed that, helped that to happen. But Jordan Ellis, 93 yards on 24 attempts. Andre Lavoni, 2 touchdowns, 141 yards receiving on 5 catches. Big, long touchdown run for Alameda Zacchaeus. Virginia had 21-14 lead at halftime, and, Boise State scored right before the half, and it felt like, Virginia let them back in a bit with that short kickoff that went out of bounds. But Virginia scores in the first drive of the third quarter, 3-play drive. A quick 1-play drive on that Zacchaeus in the round that put the game sort of out of reach, 3-score game at that stage. This was a Virginia team that played with the confidence of a team that, really has not, this is a program that hasn't had a win like this. Scott, we were trying to scan our memory bank. I'm still not sure we've figured out yet, how we can compare this in terms of big wins for this Virginia program. It dates back a while before Virginia, where we can say Virginia has a win over a quality opponent like a Boise State on the road of this nature. And so this Virginia team, maybe they didn't know that they were supposed to, play a team like this close. They just went in, stepped on the throats of Boise State and really gave them no chance to get back in this game in the second half.
They did. And, I was feeling really good after that, 21-7 late in, and let Boise State get that score right at the end of the half. And I thought, well, it was nice while it lasted, but clearly, they came out in the second half and was quickly established that dominance again, and it was really not even a close game. To gauge how big a game it was, you look at Boise State, they've lost 6 home games in 110 games. So, it's a statement win when you go into Boise, Idaho and come away with a win. And, Virginia looked solid in all aspects of the game, offense, defense, special teams didn't really, other than that late in the game mishap, the snap over Benkert's head. But they showed a lot of promise. It's kind of like the early years of Tony Bennett, building some fundamentally strong play there. They didn't make the typical silly mistakes, dropping punts. We commented one time off the air or texting that we hope they fielded the punt. We didn't see any, back-breaking mistakes. And just maybe, the philosophy of Mendenhall is catching on to the players right now.
What's interesting, too, is this game started like a lot of fans thought it would probably go. Boise State takes the opening kickoff. Virginia wins the toss, elects to defer to the second half. And Boise State takes the opening drive, 7 plays, 80 yards. And within 3 minutes of the opening kickoff, they're up 7-0. And I'm scanning Twitter and the message boards, and fans are saying already, hey, maybe it's a Netflix night, things of that nature. But Virginia doesn't immediately respond. I mean, there's a couple of, punts back and forth between the two teams. Jordan Ellis' 2-yard run caps up a 9-play, 53-yard drive. Virginia takes advantage of a short field, ties the game up. A couple of touchdown passes from Benkert, 1 to Lavroni, 1 to Dowling, 21-7 just before the half. Then Boise State comes back. I mentioned the you know, the short field, the 2 minute offense, and they get the points right before halftime. It's 21-14, but I'm still seeing, you know, I think Virginia fans are kind of expecting the worst to happen. And I'm scanning Twitter, I'm scanning the message boards, and it's a 21-14 Virginia lead. Virginia played very well in the first half, no turnovers, nothing in terms of, you know, nothing that will make you think anything bad was about to happen, but you're still, the fan base is still thinking, hey, you know, we've already maybe played on this football here. To give Virginia credit then, first drive of the second half out of the locker room, 64-yard touchdown pass, Banker to Lavroni, three-play drive. I mean, so quick strike. There was no drama there. Two runs, draw the defense in, throw it over their head, Lavroni, and then that big end-around to Kaius, who otherwise had a quiet night, but that end-around made it 35-14. And then another long drive, 9-play, 70 yards, 42-14, right at the start of the fourth quarter. I mean, Virginia responded, whatever adversity there was, that score right before halftime, Virginia responds. And does so in just in very impressive fashion, to say the least, with great defense. Boise State 30 yards rushing on 24 attempts in this game, and at least 20 of those were in the fourth quarter when the game was already decided. Virginia forces a turnover. Boise State's 4 of 16 on third downs. I mean, this was a great performance offensively, great performance defensively. You know, all phases of the game, Virginia dominant.
And, you know, it looks, Chris, it looks like that the players, keep in mind, for the most part, I would imagine that all of these players, with the exception of Ben Kirtle, most of these players are still Mike London players. There may be some true freshmen out there, but I kind of doubt it. But it looks like the players are buying into Coach Mendenhall's system. And if he's getting them to buy into the system in year two, early in year two, you've got to be encouraged by the thought of what's going to happen when he's actually able to go out and start fully recruiting players from day one that buy into the Mendenhall system before they ever step foot on the grounds. If he's getting these players that aren't his recruits to buy into the system and with results like this. This was just I can't remember having seen a Virginia football game play this flawlessly. And they asked how long. It's probably been 10 years.
At least, you know, when you talk about, and even within this season, this team has really improved. We talked about the first two games of the season, the offensive line struggles. They allowed three sacks in the win over Wayne Mary in week one. The first 2 weeks combined, the running game, 147 yards on 52 attempts, 2.9 yards per carry. Last week, 5.5 yards a carry. And I mentioned again this week, you take the snap over Brinker's head away, that's lost rushing yardage officially. Even with that as a given, over 4 yards a carry in this game against the Boise State defense that came in, ESPN Power Index, we talked about this in our podcast the other day, Scott. ESPN Power Index had this Boise State defense ranked 14th in the country, and Virginia put up 440 yards of offense against this team. And so, yeah, I mean, you know, you go out there and win a game against a good team on their field, as you mentioned, 104-6 record in their last 110 home games. When that stat was read across the air on ESPN tonight, I pointed out loud, here, well, my wife's watching the game with me, that Virginia was 1-6 at home last year. They were 104-6 in their last 110 games. Virginia was 1-6 at home last year. That tells you that's a long period of success for Boise State. 32 straight home non-conference wins. That streak broken in dramatic fashion with this, you know, this huge Virginia victory. So this isn't beating somebody. This isn't, you know, beating a mid-major team. This is beating a really good team that's used to winning these games. And now Virginia goes into a bye week with the momentum of this win. ACC play forthcoming, a 3-1 record. You win a game that you're not supposed to win against a Boise State team. You know, Virginia picked seventh in the Coastal Division preseason. Nobody expecting anything, including most of us fans. All of a sudden, you start thinking, hey, you know, if this Virginia team can go out and beat Boise State, they can win 3 or 4 more games and go to a bowl this year. I mean, it's, you know, there's a lot of football to be played, but that's how you start thinking at this stage.
Well, that's exactly right. And, you know, having watched Virginia football for so long, both of us, it's just so refreshing to see glimpses of what Virginia football used to be like. And this is the way they often played. So fundamentally sound, didn't beat themselves, established a running game, had a good balance between running, passing. We talked about it. We nailed it right on the head earlier. We said that if the offensive lineman could give Ben protection, it would open the running game as well as the passing game. They did. He had another great game, no turnovers. You know, this is something that we've been hoping to see for a long time. Now, got a week off, got Duke coming in. It's just fun to just anticipate Virginia football being relevant again.
Yeah, you know, imagine that there will be actually fans in the next game. There's got to be a buzz around the program now that hasn't been there in a long time. You know, there's a week for that to build up now for the Virginia fan base, which usually by this time of year is thinking ahead to the start of basketball season. And now there's still something to play for with football. Scott and I were talking for our listeners out there. We were talking after our podcast earlier today about, well, you know, if Virginia actually wins this game, there might be some travel plans in December that have to be altered a bit for some fans. I mean, it makes you start thinking about possibilities that haven't been there for a long time. Now, that said, a couple of things that pop out to me, and they're not very significant, but they do. You know, the lack of depth still is an issue. I mean, that is what it is. But every time Kurt Benkert gets hit, my heart skips a beat because, you know, you go from Kurt Benkert, a senior quarterback who threw for three touchdowns tonight, was flawless again tonight after his school record setting performance last week. If he gets hurt, you go to a true freshman quarterback. You know, when Virginia gets these big leads, the last 2 weeks they've had huge leads in games in the fourth quarter, you see that the spring team defense, you know, there is a big step back. Those are freshmen and sophomores who are getting playing time, which is great, but you definitely see a talent gap there between the first group and the second and third groups. So it is a fine line, but, you know, okay, it's four games in. Virginia's 3-1. They have a win over Boise State. If they can stay healthy, this could be an interesting team this year for this Virginia program. And it's, yeah, you're right, Scott. It's exciting for Virginia fans to, you know, I guess by the time we play again in October, we're still a relevant football team for the first time in a long time.
We have hope, and that's what we were – that's what bringing in a coach of Mendenhall's caliber. Boy, it seemed like that game turned into a UVA football infomercial the last 10 minutes because the announcers really weren't describing the game at all. They were just praising Mendenhall and praising his leadership. And, boy, what more could you ask for? But, you know, getting back to the depth, I'm not sure we had a bunch of second-teamers in there because I'm not sure we have a second team, to be truthful. And if you notice, one question was answered tonight. It looks like Lindell Stone is – his plans are strictly to redshirt him because they brought the other quarterback in, Cross. He gets hurt on the sideline tackle, and Ben Kurt is forced back in the game with about 4 minutes.
Yeah, yeah.
So,
yeah, exactly, and has to actually – that ball snapped over his head. It's just, you know, you're up 42-14, roughly two minutes to go. That's a moment where certainly your backup's in the game. But yeah, no question. Yeah, Stone is – unless Banker gets hurt, Stone is holding a clipboard the rest of the year, and I think for Virginia fans out there after this win tonight, we can't wait until next year when Lindell Stone takes his first snap. In a live game. We hope that's the case because, you know, you don't want to burn that red shirt year. And now this team has something to play for. You're exactly right. A great observation that, you know, that's clearly an indication that Stone is you know, he's very much an emergency quarterback, even though he's listed number two in the depth chart.
You know, he may be listed number two, but there's no plans to play him because if there were, he would have been in the game tonight. And, you know, Benkert standing on the sideline, his mind clearly has left the field. He's thinking about the celebration afterwards, and then all of a sudden he's throwing back out there. Now the snap was atrocious. It was way over his head. It wasn't his fault. He just missed the snap. But you know, again, it shows that there is a depth issue, and we're going to have to keep our fingers crossed that we don't have any major injuries. We're only a third of the way into the season. You know, any still got a murderous schedule. The ESPN commentators talked about those last three games at Louisville, at Miami, home against Tech, which could be more of a home game for Tech than us, so with their fan base. So a lot of football left. A lot of things can go bad. But at least for this night, for one night, one happy Friday night, there's hope again for Virginia football.
Well, I'll say a couple things and then we'll wrap this up. But the when a schedule was announced a few months ago, it was just as murderous then as it is now. But back then we were thinking, well, what's the difference if you're 2-8 going in those games? You know, you just play your string out. But now those games actually mean something, at least, you know, as things look right now. And just think back to 2 years ago, Mike London's last season, it was roughly, I mean, it was the third week of September 2 years ago, 56-14 loss in Charlottesville. Interception on the first play of the game, returned for a touchdown by Boise State. Reverse that tonight. This program is in a different direction. So Virginia football gets the big win at Boise State. And we have an off week next week, but Scott and I will come back early next week and we'll have had more time to digest this huge win for Virginia over the Broncos, and we'll talk more Virginia football. I got more coming tonight as well, more game wrap-ups, columns, recaps, et cetera. For Scott German, I'm Chris Graham signing off. Virginia 42, Boise State 23. Wahoo-wah. Thanks for listening.